guys, should we do this? Should we act semi-professional? I mean, we don't have to go all the way.
How, like 38%?
38% professional with a cast of Legion. Yes, Aubrey?
I'm here, and I'm glad to be here, Josh.
Good intro. Good intro. It's a pleasure to meet you, Rachel.
Hello.
We all go way back.
Hello again.
It's good to see you guys. I'm a big fan of this show.
Thank you.
Legion is the show. It must have been, I mean, give me a sense of like the relief, excitement when it finally hit, because when you're reading the scripts for this and you know it's Noah Hawley, it's complex material. What, Aubrey, what? What's happening
what?
Already?
I didn't do
I'm remembering
anything.
What it's like to talk to you now.
What are you talking
you
Legion, we're talking about Legion.
I was waiting for you to respond.
I'm sorry. No, but in terms, it's complex material, it's challenging material, and sometimes audiences don't respond to that kind of material. So it must have been a relief when the reviews came in and the audience was there.
Yeah, it's a bold show, you know, and it's got its own thing going on. But it's been really fun for the feedback I've enjoyed has been when somebody's about three or four episodes in, and they say, "I have no idea what's happening, but I love it."
Right.
And I really like that. I like people enjoying their confusion a bit.
What percent of the time did you have similar reactions?
38% of the time.
That's the goal.
47.
Oh, smarter lady.
62.
Oh,
she's bold.
Yeah.
Rachel really knew what was going on.
10.
Now, what's went down?
We should just say numbers.
Okay, good. in a thousand years, that's how we're all going to communicate. 23?
Purple.
Purple 6.
So where are we at in season 2? Have you guys started shooting?
No. What are we? September the 5th, I believe.
Oh, we have. You haven't been there?
Oh, is it awkward?
Yeah.
Nothing is real.
Yeah.
You had a good run in the first season. We don't need you in the second season.
I don't know why.
What do we know officially or unofficially? How much do you know about? Yes, Aubrey, take over.
No, we don't know anything, and we can't say. We'll get in trouble.
No.
Like bad little babies.
that Noah calls you?
Yeah.
That's an odd thing. It doesn't feel appropriate.
That's what he calls you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
now wait, do you just not know or can you not tell me?
We don't really, I mean, I don't know much at all.
Right.
We've read one script and we can't really talk about it.
Okay, that's interesting. How much did you know about where your character, did you know like the whole like arc of your character over the first season for all of you? Did you, how much was like mapped up? When
I
you
feel like you knew a lot more than I did.
Yeah, a little bit.
Paranoia?
I knew like broad strokes. I knew where things would end up, but I didn't know how they would get there.
In any scene with Aubrey, she definitely knew what was going on and I had no idea.
Or I just helps pretended the character. That I did. But yeah.
There it is.
How much did you know?
Yeah, I knew everything. you know. No, we didn't really know a lot. I mean, it was just a total experiment. We're building something from the ground up. And we didn't have a lot of pressure because there was no realization of Legion before this.
Right.
So being fans of the Marvel world and wanting to just find a kind of a different path, I think, gave us a lot of freedom to not be under that pressure and explore as we went.
Is there more license you feel like now that you know there's an audience there? Do you guys all feel, does Noah feel like you're empowered to go even further and kind of like push? I mean, it already went pretty wild in the first season.
People seem to like the weird, and I think, you know, when the first time you put something like that on its feet, you know, it feels weird because you don't know if people are going to receive that weird.
Right.
But yeah, there's more.
Well,
there's
the goal is never
weird.
Like to be weird.
Just for the sake of it.
No, but it's definitely a strange show, strange material to tackle.
Right.
And yeah, it seems, you know, people enjoy strange things.
What was
things.
The strangest day on set of season one? When you think, what was the oddest thing that you were made to do?
Oddest
you
thing.
Blocked it out?
Bollywood. Bollywood was pretty odd.
That was really fun.
That was odd. Yeah,
It wasn't scripted as Bollywood. We just said they dance or dance.
Insert dance here.
Yeah.
Yeah, and so we did.
All
you know.
The dancing was strange, I would say, across the board.
Yours was really strange.
It was
strange.
Not something that we knew that would happen.
We could pick something like every day.
Right.
Like, pretty much. This is odd. Oh, that's
but things
odd.
Were scripted like that, so they dance. And
really?
You know, how is left
how,
up
why,
to.
How, why, where, what?
You know.
Is there more singing and dancing to come in season 2?
I hope so. Aubrey is definitely going to be
62.
Singing.
Yeah.
are you ready for a full-on musical episode? That's every show gets there at some season. There's the
absolutely.
Full-on.
I'm ready. Bring it at us.
Any
Hurry.
Style you'd like?
Bollywood comes to mind again. I don't know.
We could be the first Marvel
like
improv show.
Yes. Some like
where
ballads,
we just take suggestions each
Matchbox
week.
Matchbox 20.
There you go. Yeah. Matchbox 20 always is a good go-to.
Matchbox 20 style episode.
Classic. Yeah. It's come around again, mm-hmm. I feel like.
Yeah.
What about the Professor X of it all? What are we going to see? Who are we going to see? When are we going to see?
Papa. Pops?
I don't ever want to see that.
Is that what he calls him? Daddy-o?
I don't know. He's going to try a few different names before he really hits on one that, you know, because their relationship has not really been.
And you don't want to call Professor X. That's a formal way to start.
It's a bit
start
too formal for Dad, unless he insists on it.
Right.
He is British, so he might.
There was joking or non-joking conversation with Patrick Stewart at some point where he's like, I'm ready. Let's do it.
He's primed and ready. I believe it's just a question of, you know, a few minor details in the contract and something to do with jelly beans in his trailer or something. Mm. I don't know. We're going to figure it out.
British people are strange.
Would you hope that actually, do you think there's a chance that could actually come to pass?
I don't know. I mean, I think.
Is that the right way to go?
David is certainly curious about his provenance still. Mm-hmm. And I think there's a lot of questions surrounding that. It's going to take quite a bit of explaining, I think.
Is there, again, without revealing too much, in my sense is you can't reveal virtually anything, is there, do you know, like, an overarching arc mystery of season two that you can hint at?
Well, the way that Noah has been putting it, this is basically my way of stealing every phrase he's used this morning, but is that, you know, if season one was about the battle with the enemy within, certainly some of that, or a large part of that enemy, is now without.
Right.
And there's a U2 song about that.
Within or without?
Something like that.
Well, right.
Pretty close. Beautiful day.
With or without you.
With
that's
or without
the wrong.
Yeah. You.
I thought it was within or without you. That's my cover of it.
Right.
This will be edited out. Don't worry.
Within or without you.
Just going live. Doing it live.
What?
Huh?
Yeah. U2. It's a. They were a band. in the what?
So, let's talk about Comic-Con.
Oh yeah.
Shall we? That's where we are.
We're here.
Did you realize that?
Yes, live. We are here.
Correct. Good. That's the first trivia question you got right. So, a couple hot button things everybody talks about at Comic-Con, because we all enjoy many of the same shows. Game of Thrones. Any Game of Thrones fans here?
Yes.
How will Game of Thrones end? Bold predictions?
With a musical episode sung by Ed Sheeran.
Were you pro Ed Sheeran? Because this became a controversial
thing. Very pro Ed Sheeran.
Is Ed Sheeran on Game of Thrones?
He had a little cameo last week.
Is that true?
He's going to be on Legion next year.
What? Who is that?
Star Wars spinoff. What's the Star Wars spinoff you want to see?
Oh.
What? What does that mean?
Like an office comedy, maybe? Like a workplace comedy? Star Wars workplace comedy.
Yeah, that's what the answer I was looking for.
A soccer drama with BB-8.
Right. Yeah, bend it like BB.
We'll work on that.
I thought it was pretty good.
There you go.
And Pie in the Sky, are we at Beauty and the Beast? It's not like, we're not talking like a franchise necessarily, but do you think
aren't
there's any?
We?
Sorry?
I don't know. It's all right. What do you mean?
Well, like, I don't know.
Is there more Beast?
Exactly.
Beast goes to Italy?
There you go.
We could work on that too.
Beast like vacation?
Yeah. Sure. Beast in Spain?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Just go around the European.
Go on motorcycles with Ewan McGregor, just sort of the Beast.
Ewan McGregor as a candlestick.
Yeah.
A candlestick driving a motorcycle with the Beast on the back.
This is, for the audience, this is how workshops work.
This
is how
people.
congratulations on season one. I can't wait to see what's in store for season two.
Thank
and
you.
Enjoy your Comic-Con, guys.
Thank you
Thanks,
very much.
Josh.
Good to see you. We did it.